Welcome. I'm Alex Franco, and I'm the ALX trainer, coach, advisor, and senior consultant at SimWell. Today, I'll be talking about comparisons, the importance to making business decisions, and how to do it. In today's world, we address real-world problems with analysis using spreadsheets and in spending time and money to implement them. And then we wait for the results to see in the real world. Well, today we have a better way of doing this. With simulation, you have a risk-free environment to model your supply chain and then implement a solution to understand the financial risk, the service levels, the costs, and the trade-offs of resulting of this implementation in the real world. This potentially could save you a lot of money, time, and headache. Today, we'll be spending time in this section. Should we implement, and what should we consider prior to making the decision? Just like any project, you begin with the analysis. You get the numbers. Is there an opportunity? Then you share your findings with the stakeholders. They see the results and decide if this is worth doing, and at the same time, they evaluate the analysis. Obviously, several questions and pushback will happen at this time. Do the numbers make sense? Did you answer their what ifs, the risks, the trade-offs? And upon reaching the last stage, you evaluate if it's worth implementing. Implementation is where the largest investment will take place. So approving to implement a change or initiative only happens when the gap of confidence is good enough to make the leap of faith. And the smaller the gap, the better feeling everybody will get. Is it the right time? Is it worth it? What's the return on the investment? What's the reward versus the risk? Is it aligned to the business? With using something like spreadsheets to make decisions, it's very difficult for stakeholders to simply rely on spreadsheets and their supply chain experience. The challenge in the real world is that the decision maker will most likely have many questions, which will require the analyst to go back and validate. This issue becomes time consuming, and many times analysis will get a lot of time and effort. Without simulation, you'll need to implement and wait to see the results. Where with simulation, you can rely and see the results and see if it makes sense prior to the investment. So how can ALX support this? Well, ALX has the capabilities to compare scenarios, meaning we can compare the current state of the supply chain, the baseline, to the future state of the supply chain. This can save you a lot of time and money, making ALX a great business decision strategic tool. Let's go take a look at an example. Here we have a scenario where we have incoming products coming from Brazil into North America. As you see, the products are furniture, lighting, small appliances, large home appliances, and garden equipment. And here's the view of it as the supplier provides it to the port, then to the distribution centers, and to the customers. Now, this one scenario provides results. If I go into the results section upon running it, you'll notice that we have a profit loss statement, service levels, lead times, available inventory, fulfillment, and so forth. Now, imagine that this is our baseline. This is what we have currently, and we're looking, and the company you're working with, our client, says that they want to take into consideration a variation of the demand. By going to your demand section, you can validate the actual triangular distribution of their demand. So this provides a more variation of what could potentially come from a particular customer's order. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to compare these current to future baseline to indicate what would be the trade-offs and what would happen. So let's take a look at a comparison experiment. Here, we're going to compare both these scenarios. As you see, we already have the budget comparison, the estimated demand, which is our baseline, and here is our future, right, with the triangular demand distribution. In order to do that, we're going to make sure everything's set up correctly. We could run it by pieces, we could run it by miles, and then we could get the configuration statistics done for this. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's do a compare, making sure that everything we need is there. What I did is I selected here some of the potential stats that we want to compare against. For example, the average number of vehicles, the ALT service level, the inbound and outbound processing, inventory carrying costs, max number of vehicles used, the service levels, obviously, total cost, and the costs and the utilization of the vehicles. So once I've selected what I want to compare these two against, go ahead and make a run for it. And here you go. Here are the results. So now we have our baseline versus our future. What if? As you take a look, the average number of vehicles going from the baseline to a distribution demand that's more distributed and varies a little bit more widely in their demand. You went from 13 to 15. The ALT service level by products, meaning the time that it took to provide these runs and provide the prior product to the customers. The inbound processing cost definitely went up. Inventory carrying cost went actually a little bit down. The max number of vehicles went down as well, meaning that per one day, this was the highest, while the other day, the highest was 55. The outbound processing also went up. Peak capacity went down. Profit went up. So that means we serviced, provided more products. The service level by products went down, meaning that we potentially in certain times did not have the product in our inventory. We ship more vehicles. We have a higher total cost and a higher transportation cost, and our vehicle capacity utilization went down a bit. So here is how we made a comparison between two scenarios prior to implementing. Now let's imagine we added a third one and we can make a three-way comparison. So let's just say that we took our baseline and we wanted to add 20% more demand to this particular one, and we want to identify if it makes sense. So what we're going to do is create a copy of this simulation. Here you go. I'm going to change the properties, and we're going to say that increase demand by 20%. What I'm going to do then, I'm going to go to my periods, and I'm going to say that I'm going to increase demand by 20%. Now that I've done that, we're going to make a three-way comparison now. And we're going to be using the same stats to compare. And here are the results. And here's the one, the bottom one is the one increased by 20%. As you see, the average number of vehicles increased quite a bit per day. The ELT service level by products. And voila, you have your results. And this is where decision making could happen at a very high level. But obviously, let's just say you want to compare service level by products, then you could also compare the results of each one of them like this. For example, if I go to my statistics service level and I wanted to understand the service level by our products, I could quickly add this to comparison. And this would be my baseline. Then I go to my triangular distribution, do the same thing. And then I go to my last one, where I still have to make a run for it. I save it. Go to my service level, and I can go ahead and add this last one, which would be based on my 20% increase. And there you go. There you have it. The three, you can compare at this level if you want to compare more detail in a particular dashboard. ALX can address several of your business challenges listed here and much more. ALX provides the opportunity to build your digital twin, making it the reason why I can virtually do it all. Want to know more? Follow us on SimWell on LinkedIn, where we have blogs, webinars, videos, case studies, or go to our website, www.simwell.io. If you want to talk to someone about your business challenge, our services, or get an estimate, a demo, or get an evaluation period going for you and your team, feel free to reach out and schedule a call. I hope this video was helpful and informative. Thanks for watching.